Lessons, my friend, and welcome to Theclastyle. I'm happy to have you in my home today, and from my house to yours. Today we are going to be doing a thrift flip. So guys, I went shopping. We heard about this sale that a big store was having, and I got this magazine rack. It was broken, and some of the bamboo and the fabric was coming undone. So I decided, let me try to redo it. So one of the dowels was broken, so that has to be replaced. And I just took out some of the screws, and I'm trying to take out the rest of the fabric and the bamboo part from on it. So I'm just taking out the bottom screws. Now I had this dowel packed there. I had bought it a while ago. It was $15, very expensive. Yeah, but I know, you know, by now things here are very expensive. And it was just the right size and width, so I decided to use this one to replace that was broken. So I am going to just take this bottom part off and try to see what I can come up with. So guys, this is a thrift flip road trip held by our Greenacres and Crafting Cousins every second Saturday of the month. And guys, oh my gosh, you know, these thrift flips are amazing. You can transform almost anything into something so different, and I quite enjoy doing these thrift flips. And do check out in the description box for the playlist provided, and do head across to the our Greenacres and Crafting Cousins. Their information is going to be in the description box. So I'm continuing to take everything apart, ripping out all the sides. I will be reusing certain parts of this and getting rid of the bamboo part of it. So just continuing to rip everything off. So I had a piece of leather over from my upholstery, the puffs that I did, and I decided to use the bamboo part as a template. I'm going to cut out two sides. I'm going to have one for the back and one for the front. And guys, if you did not see the price of this before, it was $5 at the thrift store. So I got this for $5. There were a whole lot of them, but I decided, let me just take one, because I don't think I'm going to be doing anything else with that. So what I'm doing is just replacing the leather part from the bamboo. And I'm going to use my glue gun, and I'm going to glue everything in place. It's going to hold it pretty strong because I've done something similar to this already. So I'm just tucking everything, pinning them in place. And then I'm going to come in with my glue gun and glue the top, the sides. I'm reusing the bias binding on the sides, and I'm reusing the top part of it, that's a fabric, and also the bottom part of it. So mainly I'm just changing the leather aspect of it. This is how it's looking. I think it's turning out so cute already. And I'm just going to be replacing the wood back in the inside. Now I decided not to paint the wood or anything. I like this natural look, and I even left the newer dowel that I had. I did not repaint it, so I just left the wood part of it like that. You know, maybe I would stain it after, but you're not gonna see it anyways. So I just found that the front was looking a bit bare, and I had some nail tack strips from my puff, and I just put them with some glue at the top. And I got a piece of my upholstery fabric, and I cut out a shape, and I did adhere it to it. It gives off a kind of like boho kind of style, you know. So this is how it's looking. It fits really nicely. It's very sturdy, and I have it here under the table where my husband puts his newspaper and such. So just a replacement of fabric and a few additions, and something can look so totally different. So this was a very inexpensive thrift flip, And I quite enjoyed doing this, and it's very useful, guys. Now, the other one was a canister, little canister that I found. I paid $2 for it. It was from a Christmas section. And I am using some black spray paint, and I spray that, let it dry good. And I also spray the cover of it. I'm just using ordinary scotch tape. And I am running, I think this was a bronze paint color on it. I will give this 2 coats and let it dry very well before I remove the tape on it. I'm also going to be doing the lid of it. I thought I wanted to put some lines on this part of it also. I think it would have tied in really nicely with the canister. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just running the bronze onto it, and I'm going to let it dry and then repaint it. So I'm removing the tape, and this is how it's looking. And this has been very easy, and look at how it has transformed. I just have some little screws and hooks and eye hooks and some other little accessories in here, and I'm putting the lid back on, and it really looks so lovely. Who would have thought it was a Christmas piece? And I did not want the lines all running in one direction. I love the different contrast for the lines. So I did paint the lines in a different direction. So do check out in the description box and check out the other ladies' channels. And guys, I will see you soon. Hope you have enjoyed, and I'll catch you later. Bye, guys.